Scotties. I'm Abby Depp. Welcome to G-Town You Know. On today's episode, the Scottie football team wins a playoff game. The band performs for our elementary schools, and Glasgow High School teachers and students take a recess. The Scottie Channel also takes a look at the recent election for Kentucky governor. But first, the headlines.
Hey Scotties, I'm Mahdi Zulfikar, and these are the headlines. And Grayson finally let me out of her locker. Thanks for asking. The Scottie singers performed at the annual Bobby Driver Singing for Scholarships concert at the Plaza Theater last weekend. They will return to the stage in a couple of weeks when they perform at Acapulosa at Bowling Green High School. Congrats to Hadley Stinson, a student at Glasgow Middle School, for winning the Erase the Stigma video contest for mental health. Stinson's video won the competition for the school district and the region, and I think we have footage of that video.
Oh, ashes fall from burning dreams. Oh, never live through times like these. Oh, if you're trying hard to breathe in the dark.
In other news, Kentucky incumbent Governor Andy Beshear won re-election Tuesday night after defeating former Kentucky Attorney General Daniel Cameron. While Beshear won the state by over 60,000 votes, Cameron took Barron County by around 2,000 votes. In his victory speech, Beshear said Kentucky didn't vote to move left or right, but to move forward, jokingly adding that Kentucky also chose Jack Harlow over Sarah Huckabee Sanders. In other news, Governor Beshear may face an uphill battle when trying to work with the Republican-led Kentucky legislature during their upcoming session. Kentucky Senator Damon Thayer, the Senate Majority Leader, said Tuesday night that there is no incentive or reason for the Kentucky legislature to work with Beshear. And those are the headlines. Here's another Scottie Channel reporter with the next segment.
Mason, are you going to vote when you're eligible?
Yes.
Why?
Because I think it's just good like to vote, go out and vote because like you want the best person there for the people. You just don't want somebody in there that's just there to be there.
That's smart, Mason.
A few weeks ago, this field was full of a bunch of Glasgow High School students, but it was not for a Scottie football game. It was for a pastime we should all know, recess. So, Mr. Gee, what did you think about recess?
I really liked it. Mr. Norman kind of brought that in and kind of mentioned it to me and Coach Mack, and we were like, you know, actually, I really like that. I like the idea of kind of getting a little bit back to our roots, you know? Like, elementary school, we had recess. Why couldn't we have it in high school? So, really liked it. It was a lot of fun.
So, what did it mean for, like, the teachers to get involved with that?
I think it was also helpful because you had some teachers that would maybe take some time just to, you know, decompress and take a little bit of time to themselves. So it was also for the teachers as well as the students. But I also felt like, too, there were some teachers that went outside and were able to kind of, like, socialize and interact with students beyond just the classroom, right? So I know that there was a few footages of me and a handful of kids throwing around a football. Poorly, I might add. But it was nice to let them see that, like, I'm just a person, I'm just a human. I enjoy throwing around some football from now and again, you know, so it was nice to kind of have a different context to set up a different kind of culture and set up. So,
thank you.
I'm gonna bring it back.
Y'all think about recess?
I liked it. I thought it was nice.
It was awesome. We should do it again.
All right.
So I'm here with
Ryan Randall.
So what did you think about the entire recess thing last week?
I think it was awesome. Blast from the past. Don't get to do much anymore. I had a great time. Got to play some walk ball. Did pretty good. It was a great time. Shout out Joey Norman for letting us do that for sure.
All right, thank you.
Alrighty, Scottie Channel. Today I am here with
Nick.
And I'm Wesley. Nick's going to ask me a few questions today.
Alright, Wesley, so what's your opinion on the entire recess thing we had last week?
You know, I thought it was great. I ate up some ice cream, and I gobbled down like four of them things. I was here with my fellow peers, Vanover. We were out there together. We had a good time. And I'd like to thank you for Mr. Norman and everybody who just made it possible. I'm hoping that I got like a 27 on my ACT. Again, thank you, Nick. Hand over to Gillette behind the camera. That's my guy. Shout out Mr. Perky. Shelton right here. My dog. Morgan. Haley. Emily. And I mean, that's all I can say. Hand over there.
What's your name and grade?
Kayla, and a freshman.
Jordy, I'm a freshman.
What do y'all like about recess?
I like that you can like socialize with people throughout the day.
Yeah. It's a very good brain break.
Okay, what do y'all want to have at recess next time?
I think we should have a Powder Puff girls football game.
If it's during this weather, I say hot chocolate.
Let's see what the Breezy Boys do when I mess up their mic. That's better.
What's up, Slasco Goddies and other viewers? We're back, Week 12 Weather Report. I'm Baby Breeze.
I'm Little Breeze.
I'm Big Breezy. Tonight I got the Hart County Raiders. Big district matchup, round two of the playoffs. It was a great game last time we played them. Hoping for a great game tonight. Looking forward to it.
You know, I'll hit you with the weather. We had a warm week this week, but at kickoff should be 48 degrees. 3 mile an hour northeast wind. It's blowing that cold back through. A little bit Kentucky weather, you know. Ain't it weird?
A little bit bipolar out here. For the pressure, we're looking at 30.02 inches of mercury, which is high because it's a playoff game. You want to hit us with the visibility, big guy?
Round two of the playoffs, you know, there's going to be good visibility. 18-mile visibility. Almost see Mumfordville from here. The Elma is that's about it. We're in big blue with it, round two of the playoffs. You know, we're in big blue. It's sturdy. It ain't going nowhere. I think we can fit
35 plus. Over. I'm taking the over too.
Theme for the student section tonight, bro.
Pajama night, man. Kick off 7 o'clock. So might want to bundle up a little. It should be getting colder as the game goes on.
What are both of y'all wearing in the student section?
You want to hit them with it?
And that was a surprise for them.
I'll probably throw on a onesie.
I'll probably wear some jeans.
Maybe a little Christmas pajamas.
Getting the Christmas spirit. What do they say, Bo?
It's a bad night to be a Raider.
Eat them up.
For our special guest today on the weather report, we got P-Mac McGowan, Parker McGowan. Yes, sir. That's my guy. Let's go ahead and sit it down. Let's go, Parker. Let's go. He's a junior for the Glasgow Scotties. And what's your height and weight?
About 6'2", 360.
He's a big boy, all right? He plays nose guard. He does a little bit of everything for us. You got a question for Parker?
Yeah. What is your go-to pregame meal, Park?
A ham sandwich and a bottle of water.
Ham sandwich?
No catfish?
No catfish. Well, you got a question for Park, man?
Yeah. What is the biggest catfish that you've caught?
68 pounds. Barron River Lake.
Can we pop a picture of it right now?
And pop it. Point. Yeah. And Parker, so what do you think the Scotties need to do tonight to come out there with a win?
We need to be able to run the football, and we need to stop them on defense.
Establish a run early. I like that. Open up the pass game.
Yes.
Yes. Y'all got any more questions for Parkman?
Parkman, will you be in the woods Saturday morning for opening day of deer?
I will be in the woods opening day.
You got any biggins on camera, or can you not say?
Nah, I ain't got none on camera.
Yeah, that's what everybody.
Got a camera maybe, out.
Hey,
that's what everybody says.
Indian style. Winging it.
Is that it? Say eat 'em up, ham sandwich.
Eat 'em up,
ham sandwich.
What's up, Scotties? I'm Carly Hagen, and these are the sports headlines. The Glasgow football team advanced to the second round of the 3A playoffs after defeating McLean County 62-38 last Friday on the road. Here's a quick recap of the game.
In the first round of the 3A playoffs, the Glasgow Scottie football team took on McLean County last Friday night. The Cougars struck first when they rushed for a touchdown and converted the two-point conversion with about 8 minutes left in the first quarter. The Scotties responded with a touchdown of their own when junior quarterback Easton Jesse faked the handoff and rushed for the score. Glasgow later took a 14-8 lead when Jesse threw a screen pass on a 4th-and-6 to sophomore Daylon Thomas for a 45-yard touchdown. McLean County responded in the second quarter and took a 2-point lead when they scored a touchdown off a slant and converted the two. The Scotties answered right back with a rushing touchdown from senior Mason Arms, but the Cougars responded with a run up the middle for another score. Glasgow tried to put some more points on the board before the end of the first half, but a turnover led to another McLean County touchdown. Down by 10 points at the half, Glasgow players told the Scottie Channel that a very motivational speech by offensive coordinator John Myers really got them back on track. And whatever Myers said worked, because the Scotties went on to outscore the Cougars 40-6 in the second half for a 62-38 victory.
The Scotties will travel to Hart County tonight for a district rival rematch. If you're unable to attend the game, you can watch a live stream at scottiechannel.com. Mark your calendars. Glasgow High School will host Meet the Scotties Winter Sports at 6 p.m. on Monday, November 20th. Please make plans to come out and support all of our student athletes. And those are the sports headlines. Until next time, follow GHS Athletics on social media for the latest in Scottie sports news. Go Scotties!
This is probably one of my favorite days of the year just because it's our first opportunity to really kind of see the twinkle in the kids' eyes where they kind of start to associate what an instrument looks like and what it sounds like. And, you know, you can tell the wheels start to turn as far as, you know, whether they're interested in being in the band program. And, you know, it's something like this. There's so many different parts that are moving at all times. And so they're kind of able to see some aspects that they may not have previously known. So we're really excited about today.
I'm just like, I just want to show them like what my favorite part about band is.
Just really showing them what like the different instruments and like hopefully they'll join.
What was it like when you were a student here?
I was like, wow, this is really cool. I want to do it someday.
Seeing all the cheer and lights in their eyes, the spark to get them to join band. I went South Green. It's always my favorite day of the year.
Well, I'm really proud. This is, I think, my 13th year of teaching, and this may be my most prideful, just from a standpoint of how far the kids have came. You know, a large portion of our group is made up of middle school students, so they're really young. But you would never know it by how well they sound, how well they play, how well they march. They're committed to the team and really have each other's back, and really part of a great big band family. So really, really proud of them.
Hey Scotties, have you listened to 1989 Taylor's version? Today, we...
Landon Gillette Takeover here. Did you guys know when Metro Boomin was only 16, his mom had to drive him down to Georgia every weekend just so he can make beats for Gucci Mane? Type of town we on, type
of town we on. Wesley.
Boone.
What grade are you in?
11.
12th grade.
Tell me how you feel about this song. Waking up, feeling like the thing for one. Count up my ones, lacing up my favorite ones. One of a kind, one of one, the only one. Got one shot and one chance to take it.
Pretty sick. What is that from?
This is from the new Spider-Man movie.
Oh, actually, I've not seen the movie, but the soundtrack is pretty swing by Fulton, patty
cornbread. Who am I here with?
Ryan Randall.
Cash Wells.
Frankie Cianci.
What grade are you in?
I'm a senior.
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 I just need you to tell me how you feel about this song.
Type of town we on. All the way live, all the way live, yeah. All the way live, all the way live. All the way live, all the way live. All the way live, all the way live.
Type of town we on, type of town we on. Type of town we on, type of town we on.
I like the beat drop.
That's a Landon Gillette type beat. Yeah.
Gillette, did you make this beat?
I did, actually. That's actually my beat. I'm actually suing Metro Boomin right now.
And who am I here with?
Marcus Thoreau.
Mr. Davis.
And I just need to tell me how you feel about this song. Stop now.
I'm kind of old school, and I just kind of keep it that way.
That's a bop. That's fire.
You like it?
Yeah.
All right.
Who am I here with?
Hudson Stahl.
Hudson, what's your favorite school lunch?
General Tso's chicken.
Any specific reason to that?
You know, it's got some good spice seasoning, just overall solid meal.
Frankie, it's bulking season. What's your favorite bulk school lunch?
Gotta go with the crispito. The spice is just something else. I mean, the crunch you get from that tortilla, I mean, it's heavenly. You know, you don't get that at schools anywhere else but Glasgow High School. Thank you very much.
Those are some crazy adjectives. Thank you, Frankie.
So we're here with?
Marcus Thoreau.
And what's your favorite school lunch?
Probably the garlic pull-apart things. Them things fire.
Yeah, they are. And why? Why are they your favorite?
They just taste the best, especially when you dip them in ranch. They mad delicious.
True flex.
All right, Cash, what's your favorite school lunch and why?
You're going to have to go with Crispitos. You know, it's got that crispy shell, like Frankie said. You bite into it, the spice hits your tongue, the flavors just melt on it, and then it's just a shame they don't serve it anymore.
That's awesome, dude. It is a shame.
What is your favorite school lunch?
My favorite school lunch is pizza, you know. And the only reason I like pizza is because I like the cheese, I like the pepperoni, you know what I'm saying?
That's valid.
Davey Williams, the chicken Alfredo.
Any specific reason to that?
You just can't go wrong with it.
Absolutely, thank you. We're here with Hayden Veach. Hayden, what's your favorite school lunch, man?
I'd probably have to be the General Tso's chicken.
General Tso's, okay. We got General Tso's chicken. So what's your full name?
John Ryan Byrd.
So we got John Ryan Byrd. What's your favorite school lunch, man?
Chicken strips, chicken tenders.
So chicken strips, chicken tenders. That's two. So, which one's your favorite?
Buffalo chicken dip.
Buffalo chicken dip. Wow. Okay, hot take. Thank you. Thank you, John Ryan Bird. Who am I here with?
Cooper.
Cooper and
Anthony.
Anthony. What's y'all's favorite lunches?
Probably the General So chicken.
Pizza.
Popular. Two popular answers. Thank you, guys.
I'm here with
James Anasoto.
What's your favorite grab and go?
Sausage and biscuit.
Why?
Because the sausage is very good, tastes great.
What is your favorite grab and go food?
The chicken biscuit with jelly.
You want to say why? Or?
Because it's good.
That's what I'm saying. Go Scotties.
Yeah.
What's up, Scotties? I'm here with Paxor.
And Paxor, what's your favorite grab and go?
Apple juice.
All right, Scotties, I'm here with Big Tay. Big Tay, what's your favorite grab and go food?
My favorite grab and go food is the cinnamon cereal bar.
I'm here with Miss Edwards. Miss Edwards, what's your favorite grab and go food?
Oh, yogurt is totally my favorite grab and go.
The cinnamon popcorn.
So you gotta go cinnamon over like blueberry?
Yeah.
I'm here with Ryder Heller. Ryder, what's your favorite grab and go food?
It's gotta be the egg and cheese biscuit.
You can want to say why, you have a specific reason or anything?
It's just tastes the best. It tastes the best.
That's what I'm saying. Thank you. All right, what's your favorite grab and go food?
Probably donuts.
What's your favorite grab and go food?
Probably gotta be donuts.
You want to say why?
It's easy, quick, tastes good.
That's what I'm saying.
Thanks to everyone who helped out with today's show. Until next time, this is G-Town You Know.
This is hula hooping competition. We're gonna see who can hula hoop the longest. Ready, set, go. Oh, TK, yeah, all right.
Who am I here with?
David.
David, I heard you had some opinions to share. Would you care to elaborate?
I think, so I like my lunch table, right? But they all stay on their phone the whole time and they don't talk to me, man.
Come on. Horrible friends. Do better, guys.
We gotta get this done.
Oh, is it already rolling?
Stinsons.
And we're here with
Madi Sofa Car.
Madi, do you plan to vote for the elections?
I don't think I can because I'm not legal.
Okay, you should probably look into that. I think. That's,
I don't think I can be here right now, but you know, make sure you don't put that on.
Go stay safe.
All right, yeah, thank you.